Yeah, so I'll show you something called pitch shifting. Go ahead and type a word gizmo. There are several ways to do anything in Max, but this one I particularly like. And go ahead and open the help file and just go ahead and copy this thing. It says a PFFT tilde and whatever, and then just copy all the way up to here the translation ratio. And then copy, close, I moved something there. So here it goes. As easy as that. This number is at the moment only thing to kind of consider. 4096 is what they call the window size. So if you have a long, not long, a low sound with a long wavelength, you want a big number like this. For example, cello, instruments like cello, maybe trombone. I have not processed trombone before, but I have cello, contrabass. Maybe this is a way to go. So it will give you a better resolution, except that if you do that, there's going to be a timing delay. So for violin, it seems to be okay with a number 1024. So that's what I use personally. And I'll go ahead and add a float number here. This is going to be your interval, and let's just process me. So I'm going to sound like this. You can hear me, right? You can hear me. So if I just don't do that and then go through the PFFT, which is not doing anything right now, but let's say I want my voice to be shifted by the fifth, which is seven semitones.
You, there you go. I am lower.
So you can do that with maybe two of them if you like. Instead of sending both to the one channel, I can send this one to the right. And it's a little messy here. Crisscrossing applesauce here. Okay, well, you know what I'm doing. So I have left channel that's going to minus seven, fifths below, and let's make this like, I don't know, minus four, third below, major third below. Okay.
Hello, it's me. Hello, it's me.
And
And
you
you can
can
change this interactively
interactively
if
if
you
you
want.
want.
So,
So,
you, it's me.
it's me. Okay, it's me. You might be annoyed.